When you purchase something of high value, whether it be a makeup product or a jewelry item, it's best to handle it with care. Over time, these products may break, crack, or tarnish, but that doesn't mean you have to dump them in the trash. There are quick and easy ways you can restore your precious investments using items that are commonly found around your home. If you have a broken compact or two, you'll want to stay tuned to see how easy it is to bring it back to life. If this is your first time visiting our channel, don't forget to subscribe and please give this video a big thumbs up. Today we'll be showing you 10 brilliantly easy ways to restore damaged things. Dry mascara. We're sure you know how amazing it feels to finally find a mascara that gives you the long, voluminous lashes you desire. Drugstore brands can cost you around $5 to $7, but if you splurge and buy mascara from a luxury brand, you can very well end up spending up to $30 a tube. One thing most beauty lovers complain about the most is how fast mascara dries up. They typically have a lifespan of about 3 months, but it seems like no matter how tightly you apply the cap, the liquid formula always seems to get stiff and cakey in no time flat. Thankfully, there's a way for you to bring your dry mascara back to life so you don't have to spend a ton of money on a new one. All you have to do is grab a bottle of eye re-wetting drops. Make sure to stay away from eye drops that get rid of redness, like Visine for example. You specifically need products that are made to moisturize eyes. Next, just add a few drops of the solution into your mascara to bring back the moisture. Give the application a few pumps to break up the clumpy pieces, and that's all there is to it. This simple hack will take your mascara from lumpy and dry to nice and smooth. Don't believe us? Give it a try for yourself.
Hey guys, we are so excited to announce we are producing our own original content. Head over to The Trendy for the best DIYs, fashion tips, makeup hacks, and so much more. We are sure you're going to love it. And be sure to let us know what you think in the comment section. We love to hear from you. See you there.
Broken lipstick. Just like mascara, finding the perfect shade of lipstick is a struggle in itself. Once you discover a brand and color that you really love, you probably want to hold on to it for as long as possible. But as most makeup lovers know, there's always the possibility that your lipstick will snap in half and break right before your eyes. If this has ever happened to you, there's no need to cry over your broken makeup product any longer. All you have to do is perform this simple beauty hack to bring your lipstick back to its original form. To start, you'll need your broken lipstick and a lighter. If you're not comfortable using a lighter on your own, ask an adult to help you out just to play it safe. Next, take the lighter and heat up the part of the lipstick that's still attached to the tube. Then grab the broken piece and heat it up at the bottom for a few seconds. Then carefully stick it back onto the top until they fuse together. You can then use a paper clip to sculpt the lipstick from top to bottom to make sure it's nice and secure. When that's all done, you don't want to apply it to your lips right away. There's one more step in the process. Pop your lipstick into the freezer and allow it to sit for a few minutes until it becomes solid again. Once you take it out, you'll realize your lipstick is back and better than ever. If this seems too complicated and too much trouble for you, you can always just buy a new one. But that would mean spending even more of your hard-earned money. Prevent accidents. Beauty lovers, we've all been in this situation before. You pull out your compact to touch up your makeup throughout the day, and then suddenly, your compact magically escapes your grip and goes crashing to the ground. You let out a huge scream and you secretly hope to yourself that the contents inside are still intact. When you reach down to pick up your compact and slowly open it up, your worst fears are confirmed. It's completely ruined. A broken compact has the ability to ruin your whole day, and once it's broken, there's not much else you can do about it but suck it up and try to salvage the hundreds of tiny pieces that are left. If you never want to go through the pain of having your favorite compact get demolished ever again, this next trick will prevent an accident from happening. Take all your favorite compacts and insert a circular cotton pad into each one. This pad will keep your powdered product and the mirror inside of your compact from breaking. It provides a nice little cushion so you don't have to cringe whenever you accidentally drop your makeup on the floor. You can keep the pad inside at all times just to play it safe, and this way, you'll always know that no matter what, your compact will be protected. Sharpening trick. If you use eyeliner and brow pencils to perfect your makeup look, you probably understand how hard it is to sharpen them. No matter how expensive your sharpener is, it probably never seems to get your products as pointy as they were when you first purchased them. Sometimes the sharpener causes pencils to crumble when they hit the blade. As you keep spinning the pencil around and around, you lose more and more product. This is why so many people spend so much money on various eye pencils. They never seem to last very long because they always get eaten by a wicked sharpener. Well, guess what? Those days are now over. This beauty hack will protect your precious pencils. The next time you need to sharpen your pencils, Stick them in the freezer for a few minutes beforehand. You'll want to wait until the pencil becomes hardened, so 10 to 15 minutes will usually do the trick. Then, once you take them out of the freezer, proceed to sharpen them as you normally would. You'll notice that the pencils no longer crumble when they come in contact with the blade. This trick will help you save time and a lot of money. It will also prolong the life of your eyebrow and eyeliner pencils. Give it a try and let us know how it worked for you. Old polish. Open nail polish usually has a shelf life of about 2 years. Once a bottle is opened, some of the ingredients will evaporate, and this causes the polish to thicken and separate over time. Nothing is worse than reaching for your favorite polish color and realizing it's too dry and sticky for you to use it. But we're going to show you how you can restore your old polish so that you can get a few more manicures and pedicures out of it. If your nail polish has thickened up, just grab a little bit of nail lacquer thinner. You might already have some at home, or you can purchase it for pretty cheap at your local store. Add about 2 drops of the thinner at a time and shake the bottle a bit. If the polish still seems to be too thick, add a little more thinner until it becomes more smooth. You can keep repeating these steps over and over until the polish becomes the consistency you desire. Just make sure you shake the bottle after placing 2 drops so that the thinner can work its way through the polish. When you're finished, you'll notice that your favorite nail color is ready to be used once again. There will come a point where you'll have to dump your old polishes, but up until the 2-year expiration date, feel free to continue using this hack instead of wasting money on a brand new bottle. Shiny jewelry. You can always take your jewelry to a jeweler or have it professionally cleaned. Or you can simply spruce up all your shiny baubles by trying this brilliant hack. You probably thought ketchup was the perfect condiment for your burgers, fries, and hot dogs, and it is. But it's also the best ingredient that can be used to shine up your tarnished jewelry. When no one's looking, go ahead and snag the ketchup bottle from your kitchen. Then squirt a small amount of it onto a paper towel. Take your silver jewelry and gently rub the tarnished areas using the paper towel covered in ketchup. If you don't notice a difference in the condition of your silver, allow the ketchup to sit on your jewelry for 15 minutes. Then rub it in with a soft cloth and rinse it clean. If your jewelry has a textured surface and lots of dips and holes in it, you can easily get into these areas by replacing the paper towel with a toothbrush. Put a bit of ketchup on the brush and start scrubbing away inside the tiny crevices until your jewels become nice and sparkly. Once you see how great this hack works, you'll never spend money on expensive jewelry cleaner ever again. Ketchup, it's not only delicious, but it comes in handy when it's time to restore dirty items too. Save your brushes. Most makeup lovers have dozens of brushes in their collection. There's literally a brush for everything. There's one to apply foundation, to apply lipstick, to contour, and to apply powder, just to name a few. If you've invested a lot of money on expensive brushes, you probably want to make sure they stay in perfect condition for a long time to come. But over time, the bristles in most of these brushes begin to weaken. Every time you wash your brushes, a few bristles may detach from the base, and soon enough, your brush will be looking a bit thin and sparse. This next tip will save your brushes from losing all of their hairs, so you can enjoy them and continue using them for a very long time. The next time you notice your brush seems to be losing its bristles, grab a set of pliers. Take the pliers and grip it right around the metal part of the brush. Make sure to squeeze the metal piece tightly. This will help to secure the bristles, and it will also keep them in place the next time you use them. This is such a quick and easy hack that most people aren't aware of, but we're so glad we could share it with you. No one wants to spend money on things when they don't have to, and this trick will definitely save you a ton of cash in the long run. Turn powder to cream. If you get down to the last bit of powder in your shadow, you don't have to toss it and buy a brand new one. You can restore that old product by turning it into something brand new. Anyone can do this DIY makeup trick, and we guarantee once you try it, you'll want to convert all of your powdered products into creams. First, you'll need to break up your powder into small pieces. Next, take a bit of coconut oil and pour it all over the powder until it's nice and saturated. Make sure you pour slowly so you can control just how much coconut oil is being used. Then, use your finger or a wooden stick to mix the product and oil together. Smooth out all the bumps and make sure the product spreads evenly into the case. You'll know you're all finished when your cream powder is smooth without any lumps or bumps. Then it's time for the fun part. Now that your product is all done, you can apply it to your eyelids by using your fingertips and blending it into your skin. This hack is perfect when the winter months come around. Many makeup artists suggest switching from powder to cream products when the temperatures take a dip. Cream products have moisturizing elements that absorb into our skin, allowing them to last longer during harsh elements. So don't hesitate to convert all of your powders to creams in preparation for fall and winter. Eyeshadow to polish. Have you ever broken your eyeshadow and didn't know what to do with all the pieces? What if we told you you could turn it into nail polish? Listen up, because we're going to show you exactly how it's done. If you have a broken eyeshadow and you don't really want to splurge on a new nail polish, here's what you can do. Continue to break the powder until it's in small pieces. You can also mix various powder colors together to make your own unique shade. You'll also need a bottle of clear nail polish, a knife, a Q-tip, and a mixing bowl. Gently tap the loose powder into the bowl. Then take your knife and continue to smash and flatten any larger pigment bits until they turn to dust. Next, use the brush on your clear nail polish and add 25 to 30 drops of nail polish into the bowl of eyeshadow. Take your Q-tip and stir the mixture together until it's well blended in the form of a colored liquid. If your formula seems too thin, just add more powder. If it's too thick, add more polish. Keep adding products until the consistency is just right. The smoother the formula, the better it will apply to your nails. Next, start painting your nails right away. If you allow the polish to sit and be exposed to the air for too long, it will dry out quickly. When you're all done, apply your clear top coat to give the color some shine, and voila! You just made your own custom nail polish out of eyeshadow. Broken eyeshadow. Speaking of broken eyeshadows, we understand not everyone is down to turn their powder into nail polish, so we have another brilliant way you can restore your damaged shadow. Instead of pouting over your broken compact, there is a really simple fix that will help you restore it. First, take a spoon and break down the powder into even smaller pieces. Next, take a little bit of rubbing alcohol and pour on top of the broken pieces. Using your finger, spoon, or a wooden stick, spread the alcohol all over the product until it's nice and smooth. Make sure you get rid of all the lumps. Then, wait a few hours to allow it to dry. Once it's finished, the alcohol will cause the powder to harden, and it will look as good as new. The next time you accidentally break a compact, you won't even bat an eye. You'll know just what to do to fix it. This trick is as easy as 1, 2, 3, and we're so happy we're able to share it with you. Make sure to leave us a comment down below and let us know which of these hacks you'll be using to restore your damaged items. Thanks for watching!